Hi there, Yannick speaking. sh404SEF has a very exhaustive support for integrating Google Analytics in your Joomla site. There are two parts to that. The first one is just using Google Analytics to collect traffic data, and we are going to go through that in this video. And the second part is displaying analytics data in your site admin or on your site front end. And we'll have another video about that very quickly. A side note before we start, sh404SEF handles both Google Analytics and Google Tag Manager. I'll just talk about analytics from now on and mention when Google Tag Manager differs. First off, you'll of course need a Google Analytics account. Once signed up, you can create a web property. If needed, your analytics account lets you handle multiple websites, and you can just create a property for each of them. Google Analytics will give you a property ID, which is a short code that starts with the letters UA and then a number. And that's what you need to start collecting data on your site. When using Google Tag Manager, you'll also get a code. This time it will start with GTM. There's not much configuration needed to get started, really. Open sh404SEF control panel and then click to open the configuration. Go to the analytics tab. And the first thing we'll do is select which tool we want to use. We'll be using Google Analytics, which is called Universal Analytics here. If using Google Tag Manager, just select that instead. Next, we can paste our property ID into the web property ID field. When using Google Tag Manager, paste your GTM code in the Google Tag Manager ID field instead. That's it. We've done the minimal configuration. We can now save and check that it's working fine. Also note that you may have to clear Joomla cache if you use that. To be sure this is working right, we can now switch to the front end of the site and look up the page source code. You can do that on most browsers using Ctrl-U or Command-U on Macs, or with a right click anywhere on the page and using View Page Source. Scroll down a bit and here's the code that was inserted by sh404SEF. You don't have to worry about the technical details. It's exactly as required by Google. It means data is actually collected as expected. You can absolutely stop right here. Nothing more is required to collect traffic information, but we can go back to sh404SEF settings for a second and look at the more advanced options for analytics data collection. There are three settings you can change to modify Google Analytics behavior. The first one is anonymize IP. This means that the real IP address of your visitors will not be collected, but instead just a simplified version that does not allow their identification. This is important for privacy conscious websites, which should be pretty much everyone, I think. And it's something I personally always set. Then you can enable display features. This is needed if you want to perform advertising related traffic measurement. For instance, if you use Google Ads on your site. And the next one is enhanced link attribution, which allows more accuracy in measuring which link on a page was clicked by visitors to your site and might be useful for marketing, for instance. Be sure to check out Google own documentation if you want to use these two last options, as you may require a bit more configuration on Google's site. Now, sh404SEF also has one last group of analytics options, which lets you exclude some visitors. Why would you want to exclude anyone from traffic measurement? Well, for instance, you probably don't want to count yourself or any member of your team as a regular visitor. So sh404SEF lets you enter a list of IP addresses to be excluded. Typically, you would enter here the IP address of your office or maybe the address of your web developers. You can also enable or disable traffic measurement per user group or Joomla access levels. By default, all public pages visits are included in traffic, but maybe you want to remove all administrators or super users so that your visits and the visits from your teammates won't be recorded. Alternatively, you may also have registered users, logged in users you want to measure traffic. If so, we can add the registered group to the enabled group list, like so. But we can disable measurement for editors or publishers, for instance. That way you can be sure to only record visits from actual site visitors. After going through data collection configuration, as we just did, you can view results immediately by visiting the Google Analytics website and browsing through data. There's everything there, from very simple number of visitors per day down to details on where visitors came from, whether they use desktop or mobile devices, whether they came from a social network, Facebook, Twitter, which country they are from, and so on. Now, going to Google website to get traffic information can be a bit cumbersome. And to be honest, navigating through all the data it has can be really overwhelming, especially for non-technical users. So sh404SEF lets you view traffic reports directly inside your site, either in the admin or on the front end. I'll describe what it's like and how to configure that in another video, so please come back. Hope this was helpful, and thanks for watching.